Okay, welcome, ladies and gentlemen, and I'd like to call to order the Rutherford County Board of Commissioners meeting. Commissioner Turner will lead us in prayer, and then Commissioner Cook will lead us in the pledge of allegiance to the flag.
Let's pray. Father, it is good to be here again tonight. We are thankful again for this opportunity that each one of us have been afforded to represent our constituents. We ask tonight, Lord, that we honor you in what we do, that our actions are a reflection of you and good moral and sound character, and the words that we use are edifying to each other, and that we're able to have some honest discussion. I ask that you also be with our country. Lord, we are very divided right now. I just ask that you allow each one of us to be healed and to choose our words wisely and our actions very different than what we've been seeing, Lord, that we honor those who have gone before us to have the types of dialogues that we need to have as a country to be able to move us forward together. I know there's several different individuals in our audience tonight that have different requests that they need you to intercede in their lives. I just ask that you do that this evening, Lord. But we're thankful for who you are and what you've done in our lives, and I just ask that you continue to watch over us and watch over our county and country. I ask this in the name of your son, Jesus. Amen.
The United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Hey, Madam Clerk, will you please call the roll?
Commissioner Schaefer?
Here.
Commissioner Piercy?
Here.
Commissioner Jordan?
Here.
Commissioner P?
Here.
Commissioner Cook?
Here.
Commissioner Jernigan?
Here.
Commissioner Cush?
Present.
Commissioner Reed?
Here.
Commissioner Gurley?
Here.
Commissioner Turner?
Here.
Commissioner Allen? Commissioner Stevens?
Here.
Commissioner Johnson?
Here.
Commissioner Baum?
Here.
Commissioner Nipper?
Here.
Commissioner Dodd?
Here.
Commissioner Phillips?
Present.
Commissioner McAdoo?
Here.
Commissioner Kaplan?
Here.
Commissioner Gooch?
Here.
Commissioner Sereno?
Here.
We have a quorum with 20 present.
Thank you, Madam Clerk. All right, next you have received, I believe, a copy of the minutes of the last meeting, and we'll call on Commissioner Phillips.
Thank you, Mayor Burgess. I reviewed those minutes. I find them in order and move that they be approved.
All right. Second, Commissioner Cush. Anyone find any corrections or additions they wish to bring to our attention? If not, everyone in favor of approving them, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Thank you very much. Okay, next we have a time for public comments, and we do have three people that wish to speak to us tonight, so come forward and give us your name and address. And first, on behalf of the Boys and Girls Club, we have Cheryl Chestnut. Yes, ma'am, come up here.
Thank you for allowing me to speak tonight. I'm Cheryl Chestnut. I represent the Boys and Girls Club of Rutherford County. Our administrative office is on 820 Jones Boulevard. I appreciate the opportunity as a public service announcement to let you know that we've been serving our county for over 30 years. We celebrate our 30th anniversary this year. Statistically, I would like to tell you that we've served 2,700 children in the 2015-2016 school year. Our mission is to enable all children, especially those that need us most, to be responsible, caring, and serving community servants. Our children are 58% from single family homes, 41% qualify for free and reduced lunch. I heard the governor speak last week about the disparity of opportunity affiliated with this disparity of income. Our children need us, and we gladly serve them. We bus from over 40 schools in Rutherford County and the city. We're the only organization open until 7 p.m. at night, allowing parents the opportunity to commute from their jobs to our facility We have a grant that allows us to feed our members their evening meal. We provide snacks and their dinner every night. Their families are welcome to join them. We served over 120,000 meals last year. One out of five children in Tennessee go to bed hungry at night, and our children are not hungry. We're very pleased to give them consistency. Our national programs focus on academics. We partnered with the county for a referral for our reading program that has become not only a summer reading program, but an annual reading program year-round, the SPIRE program, because we know that children that can read will succeed. Their academic success, the development of their character and good citizenship, and their willing to serve their community is important. And due to volunteers and mentors in our community, they are aiming toward success. We feel like they are given hope in our club that they wouldn't feel otherwise. We serve 41 homeless children in Murfreesboro. When you see homeless on the street, you don't always recognize that there could be children involved, and 43 in our Smyrna Club. In the 2015-2016 school year, we served 152 homeless children, and I'm so pleased that we can be a consistent and safe place for them to be nurtured and loved. This week, Puckett's opened, our good neighbor on the square, and Andy Marshall chose our agency to spotlight because he's a Boys and Girls Club alumni, and he attributes his business success to the investment that mentors at the Boys and Girls Club made in his life. We aim to do that for others. We ask you for your support. We are applying for a grant. We need all the support we can get as we grow. And we want to partner with agencies that are serving children. We're not competing with anyone when we're serving our kids, and they are our future. Thank you.
Thank you. And next we have Ms. Susan Allen.
Good evening. I'm Susan Allen, president of the Rutherford Neighborhood Alliance, and I live at 2031 Nelson Lane in Murfreesboro. I hope you all received the email that we sent thanking you for the procedure you followed in resolving the corruption in the Sheriff's Department. We respect and appreciate the effort you and Mayor Burgess and Mr. McCreary put into the process that resulted in a positive outcome. With your choice of Mike Fitzhugh, we hope that the healing has begun in the Sheriff's Department and that in turn, the public will regain confidence in it as well. The Rutherford Neighborhood Alliance was formed 15 years ago to provide a grassroots forum for the citizens of Rutherford County. As you probably know, two of our main goals are to seek accountability from elected and appointed officials, and also to promote ethical behavior by elected and appointed officials. If we hear of a citizen's concern with a local government issue, we put a lot of time into researching and understanding the problem before we take a position and share our results with you. Your actions in dealing with the corruption in the Sheriff's Department proves to us that we have the same interests for honest and ethical government in all county departments and offices. We ask you to continue your vigilance, as will we. Thank you once again on behalf of all the members of the Rutherford Neighborhood Alliance and the citizens of Rutherford County.
Thank you. And next we have a request from our superintendent, Mr. Don Odom.
Thank you, Mayor Burgess, commissioners, and the other public servants in the room tonight. Thank you for this opportunity. We placed on your desk tonight a fact book, which we produce each winter, usually in January, which if you're a trivia contest person, you're interested in what year a building was built or about how much funding for schools or something that's going on, you can certainly reference that. Within this fact book, we added a sheet, which happens to be our enrollment numbers as of yesterday, and it's a breakdown by High School that'll let you see that in the growth compared to 1 year ago. You have coming up tonight also on your agenda is a request for Rockvale High School. We did move that up a year. We have grown the last 4 years since Stewart's Creek High School was built. We're averaging 494 new high school students per year. People are really coming back to us in middle and high school above the others. And there's several reasons why. I think it's program offerings, other things. And for example, today, the state of Utah and several districts were looking at our career and technical education program. They were here in our schools today looking at it. We've had groups from Hawaii. Knoxville's coming on March the 1st to look at ours. So you've got some very good things that you can be proud of. Again, thank you.
All right, thank you, Mr. Odom. That concludes our request for public comments tonight. So, Commissioner Turner, we're now ready for elections and confirmations.
Thank you, Mayor Burgess. Commissioners, on your iPad, you should see a list of notaries that we need to approve. And Mr. Chairman, I make a motion for their approval.
And a second, Commissioner Serino. All right, does anyone have anything that anyone that needs to be added to that list that we don't know about? If not, we're ready to vote. All of you in favor of that, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Thank you.
Steering would also like to fill the vacancy on the Conservation Board. Steering would nominate Mr. John Marshall. Mr. Chairman, I make a motion for his approval.
Second. And that second, Commissioner Cush. All right, any other nominations? If not, you're ready to vote. All of you in favor of that, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? All right, that's unanimous.
We also need to fill an alternate vacancy on the Equalization Board. Steering would like to nominate Mr. Travis Johnson. Mr. Chairman, I make a motion for his approval.
And a second from Commissioner Phillips. All right, if there's no other nominations pending, then all of you in favor of that, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed to that? Thank you, that's unanimous.
Steering would like to announce a vacancy on the Industrial Development Board and Health and Education and Facilities Board. And Steering would also like to announce the appointment of Judicial Commissioner Ms. Jessica Schoenfield. Mr. Chairman, that is our report for elections and confirmations.
Thank you, Commissioner Turner. All right, next is
Mr. Chairman, do we have to vote on the Judicial Commissioner?
That came up in the Steering Committee meeting. What did we decide about that? Was this just an appointment?
They vote on them.
Okay, all right. It won't hurt us if we don't have to. We'll still do it. That would be appropriate, wouldn't it? I think. All right. So we need to then.
I will. After much deliberation, Mr. Chairman, I'd like to nominate Ms. Jessica Schoenfield for the appointment of a judicial commissioner. I make a motion for her approval.
All right. And second from Commissioner Phillips. Now, any other nominations or discussion? All of you in favor of that, then please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Thank you. That's unanimous. All right. Thank you, Mr. Turner and Mr. Stevens. Next is a resolution to approve the consent agenda. And we'll call on Commissioner Phillips.
Thank you, Mayor Burgess. I've reviewed those items. I find all of them appropriate for the consent agenda. And I moved that the consent agenda be approved and adopted.
Second, Commissioner Jordan. Anyone have any item they wish to remove from that consent agenda? All right, we don't see anyone wishing to remove any of those, so therefore it's time for a roll call vote, so please cast your votes.
Anyone that did not vote and wishes to vote, or anyone who would like to change your vote, you may do so now.
Record the votes, please.
20 yes, motion passes.
All right, thank you very much. All right, there is not any unfinished business, so therefore we're ready to start on these reports by the standing committees. First, Budget, Finance, and Investment Committee, Commissioner Jordan.
Good evening. Start off with item J1A. Be it resolved by the Rutherford County Board of Commissioners that the general fund be amended as follows. Human Resources, Decrease unassigned fund balance, $10,000, and increase expenditure for evaluation and testing, $10,000, that's for drug screens. And agriculture extension, we decrease agriculture committed fund balance, $103,000, and increase maintenance and repair of buildings, $103,000, that's for an HVA system for the livestock building. And development tax, increased revenue, $1 million, increased expenditures, trustees commission, $10,000, increase restricted for capital projects, $1 million, and decrease unassigned fund balance by $10,000. That's to reflect changing of the budget for increase in collections. Resolved the 16th day of February 2017. Mr. Chairman, I so move.
And a second from Commissioner Phillips and Commissioner Turner. All right, any discussion or questions? If not, then please cast your votes.
Anyone that did not vote and wishes to vote, or anyone who would like to change your vote, you may do so now.
Record the votes, please.
20 yes, motion passes.
Item J1B, resolution. Be it resolved by the Rutherford County Board of Commissioners that the Solid Waste Fund be amended as follows. Landfill operations, decrease assigned fund balance, $416,000. Increase contract with private agencies, $396,000. Engineering services, $15,000. And crushed stone, $5,000. This is for additional work being done at the landfill and to move more dirt. Engineering costs and site plan as they're working with TDEC to fix some problems there. And it's resolved the 16th day of February 2017. Mr. Chairman, I so move.
Second, Commissioner Piercy. Any discussion? All right, please cast your votes.
Anyone that did not vote and wishes to vote, or anyone who would like to change your vote, you may do so now.
All right then, record your votes, please.
20 yes, motion passes.
Thank you.
Item J1C, resolution. Be resolved by the Rutherford County Board of Commissioners that the Ambulance Service Fund be amended as follows. Ambulance service, decrease assigned fund balance, $150,495. Increase expenditures, paraprofessional pay, $127,000, social security and related benefits. This is to revise the pay grade for EMT and paramedics. This was batted around for a couple of months at budget. In my opinion, there were some serious deficiencies in our pay level, and that's pretty much it. Resolved the 16th day of February 2017. Mr. Chairman, I so move.
Second, Commissioner Schaefer. Commissioner Gurley.
Yes, does this include an increase in pay for P2 paramedics?
No, sir, it does not.
Now, they are our most skilled people. It's a limited number, but they're the most skilled. They're the ones who've got the most time and so on into it. I really think we're making a mistake, so I would like to make an amendment to this budget amendment to include those. The amendment is to include the P2 paramedics in any pay grade changes, and that the fund balances be recalculated to reflect that.
Mr. Gurley, you'll have to be more specific, and you'll have to provide us the numbers and exactly the pay grade you're suggesting that they be moved to.
This is a plan that was worked out between HR and the administration or the supervisors, and we'll be glad to look at that part again at budget, but I mean, in my opinion, it's a little bit spur of the moment to be adjusting these numbers without looking at it in depth anymore than, and I may be speaking out of turn.
But. Yeah, I'll withdraw that, but I really think we're shooting ourselves in the foot. We're gonna be coming back and having to do that, so thank
you. Any other discussion? Commissioner Jernigan. Well, there are the same number of steps in every grade. The paramedic twos are one grade above what this amendment would put the paramedic ones. But I think you folks that want to do that need to start back with the Public Safety Committee and bring that through, and probably bring it through the budgeting process. Commissioner Dodd.
Just going to kind of build on that. Obviously, we've had some constituent concerns. Some paramedics have reached out to some of us. So thanks, Will. You kind of gave me a little bit of explanation. So it could be revisited in the near future.
And not to speak out of turn again, but Public Safety could look at this month's meeting. It'd come right to budget, be back here next month. I mean, and personally, I'd rather look at it in depth with HR and everybody contributing instead of trying to pull numbers out of this hat.
Absolutely.
Right here,
I agree completely. I think your response was good. I just needed to make that comment.
Commissioner Schaefer.
I am on. Stuck in my mind that EMS did give a reason why they did not include the paramedic twos in this, and I think it was because of the amount they were making. But part of this resolution that came through budget was that in this coming budget process, all public safety personnel, their pay grades will be looked at and reevaluated.
Okay, any other questions or discussion? Commissioner Johnson.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I got a call on this, and the disparity somewhere along the way in the pay grades was a concern of the lady that called me. And I'm going to vote for this, but I think we really need to go back and address this, if that would be agreeable to everyone.
Public safety.
All right. Anyone else? Mr. McAdoo.
Do we need a motion for public safety to look at this for next month?
I think public safety can manage this issue themselves if that's what they so choose. And EMS leadership can come to public safety and suggest anything they choose to do.
So we do not need a motion on that?
I don't think you need to. I mean, that's something they can work on and deliberate on. Mr. Johnson.
I think we could rely on the gentleman's agreement that public safety would revisit this along with the budget.
And just as Mr. Schaefer said, when public safety does that, they're going to have to continue the journey on every public safety employee they have, especially law enforcement and detention officers. This is going to be a major amount of resources and dollars that's going to take to actually address all of these issues. This one starting just the escalation of that one and others, even within EMS itself, not just paramedic twos. All right, any other discussion? If not, we're ready to vote on this motion that has been presented to us here for EMTs and paramedic ones, basically. Please cast your votes.
Anyone that did not vote and wishes to vote, or anyone who would like to change your vote, you may do so now.
Forward the votes.
19 yes, 1 no. Motion passes.
Item J1D, resolution. Be it resolved by the Rutherford County Board of Commissioners that the highway fund be amended as follows. Capital outlay, decrease assigned fund balance, $663,300. Increase expenditures, highway equipment, $663,300. This is to purchase 4 dump trucks and 2 four-door pickup trucks. I will tell you that in last year's budget, they had proposed a couple of dump trucks for the highway department. They pulled them because they pursued a grant that did not come through. The last time they bought any dump trucks was in 2006. They deferred buying any while there were different changes in the emission rules and laws with trucks. And this is replacing, correct me if I'm wrong, a couple of 93 and a couple of 91 model trucks. So I think they've gotten the good out of these trucks, and this is coming from their fund balance. Resolved this, and this had been through the road board, approved unanimously, I believe. Resolved the 16th day of February 2017. Mr. Chairman, I so move.
Second, Commissioner Dodd and others. Any other questions on this? All in favor, please say aye. Please cast your votes. Please cast your votes.
Anyone that did not vote and wishes to vote, or anyone who would like to change your vote, you may do so now.
Record the votes.
20 yes, motion passes.
Next we have item J1E, debt service fund budget amendment. Be resolved by the Rutherford County Board of Commissioners that the debt service fund be amended as follows. Development tax, increase revenue $1 million. Increase expenditures for trustees commission $10,000. And increase assigned for debt service $990,000. This is to reflect the adjustment to the budget for the increase in collections. Resolved the 16th day of February 2017. Mr. Chairman, I so move.
And second from Commissioner P. Okay, thank you. Any discussion? Please cast your votes.
Anyone that did not vote and wishes to vote, or anyone who would like to change your vote, you may do so now.
Record the votes, please.
20 yes, motion passes.
Item J1F, resolution. Funding for Rockvale High School. Whereas there is a need to plan and construct schools due to growth in the area, and whereas the Rutherford County Board of Education has anticipated the future needs of the school system, and whereas the Rutherford County Board of Education desires to proceed with the funding of the construction, equipping, architect fees, and other costs of the following project at the estimated cost approved by the various county committees. Rockvale High School, $58,970,000. Therefore, be it resolved by the Rutherford County Board of Commissioners that funding for the above-named project in an estimated amount of $58,970,000 be authorized from a future bond issue for the constructing, equipping, architect fees, and other costs for the project. Resolved this 16th day of February, 2017. Mr. Chairman, I so move.
Second from several, Commissioner Reed. All right, any discussion? If not, please cast your votes.
Anyone that did not vote and wishes to vote, or anyone who would like to change your vote, you may do so now.
Record the votes, please.
20 yes, motion passes.
Because I ever spent $58 million. Presentation of debt service fund cash flow and debt management policy for the three-star program. There is about 20 pages on your iPads for nighttime reading. If you want to read all about the fiscal strength and efficient government fiscal confirmation letter, then it's right there for your, and that's just for your presentation. No action needed on that. And the last, we've got an audit committee report, and I'm going to hand it over to the chairman of the audit committee, Mr. Charlie Baum.
Thank you. Let me take 1 minute to remind our county residents of what the Rutherford County Audit Committee is. Rutherford County's finances are audited every year, and a report is issued that reveals any audit findings. The Rutherford County Audit Committee reviews this report. You might say we audit the audit. With one exception, the members of the Rutherford County Audit Committee are not accountants. The members on this committee have way too much personality to be accountants. Instead, they are two county commissioners, one road board member, one school board member, and three at-large members. We meet two times per year, and one of the advantages of this is it helps improve our county's budget, our county's bond rating, so that when we go to the bond market, we pay a lower interest rate on the bonds we issue because, at least in part, one small part of that is because we have an audit committee that meets several times per year to look at our audit findings. Our first item on our agenda when we met on January 25th was to look at our financial audit, and the good news is we had no new audit findings, but we did have some repeat findings, and these were in the circuit court clerk's office. They had to do with deficiencies in the accounting software. But this county commission has already approved the funding to purchase new software, and in May and June, April, May, and June, there's going to be a conversion to the new software, and that should resolve any audit findings in the circuit court clerk's office. But I should acknowledge that those problems will not be corrected until June, and so these findings will reappear on next year's audit report, even though they will have been corrected. Our second item on our agenda was to look at an investigative report by the Tennessee Comptroller. This was referenced in our financial audit, and so it became part of our financial audit in that way. And there were 8 findings. I want to acknowledge that all of these predate interim Sheriff Mike Fitzhugh, and all of these items, all of these 8 findings have since been corrected. I'll give you just a couple of examples. One, the contract with Jail Sigs has been canceled and is no longer in the jail. Another example is any parties in question of potential violations are no longer with the sheriff's office. Tighter purchasing controls. Everyone now submits timesheets. So I want to conclude by thanking our elected officials and public servants for working so hard to correct these audit findings. I want to acknowledge that Melissa Harrell was at our meeting, and with Brian Robertson, we're able to outline how the conversion to the new software will resolve any findings in the circuit court clerk's office. Interim Sheriff Mike Fitzhugh and Acton Preble Acton were there as well, and were able to detail the steps that they're taking to correct the findings in the investigative report. And I want to appreciate them, thank them for their efforts, because it looks like these findings have all now been addressed. Thank you.
Thank you, Commissioner Baum. Let's see. Okay, continuing on with the agenda, we don't have a report from our Health and Education Committee tonight. And Commissioner McAdoo, we do have one item on property management.
Property Management Committee. We just had one piece of one partial that we are donating to the National Park Service. Resolution. Whereas through the delinquent tax process, Rutherford County has acquired partials 079DB008 00 located on Old Nashville Highway, consisting of approximately 1 acre, which is within the authorized boundary of Stones River National Battlefield. And whereas it is the intent and desire of Rutherford County to donate said partial to the National Park Service for inclusion within the Stone River National Battlefield, provided Rutherford County incurs no expense. And whereas it is in the best interest of the citizens of Rutherford County that the county donate said partial to the National Park Service. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the Rutherford County Board of Commissioners that Rutherford County shall and hereby does donate and give to the National Park Service for inclusion within the Stones River National Battlefield partial 079DB00800 located on Old Nashville Highway, consisting of approximately 1 acre, which gift is expressly contingent upon the National Park Service paying all costs and expenses associated with any requirements of the National Park Service to accept and acquire said partial. Be it resolved, the county mayor and other required county officials be and hereby are authorized to execute any and all documents necessary or appropriate to the conveyance of said parcel to the National Park Service and contingent upon county attorney approval of any such said document. Resolved this 16th day of February 2017, now so
second. Commissioner Cush and Phillips, second. Anyone have any questions or discussion? If not, then please cast your votes.
Anyone that did not vote and wishes to vote, or anyone who would like to change your vote, you may do so now.
Please record the votes.
20 yes, motion passes.
Thank you very much. There is not a report tonight from Public Safety, Public Works, or Steering. So that completes the regular part of the agenda. We're down to any other business, and tonight we do have a time for you getting an update on the litigation that's taking place, and we're going to have an executive session with our county attorney. Therefore, everyone that's in the audience will have to be excused, and so we'll give you a bit of time to exit, and then we will have to go off the air. We'll be telling the public that we'll be not broadcasting this live on our TV channel. So give us just a moment. Any of you may come back. We don't have any other business after this point, but you're certainly welcome to come back after we finish this session.
I did make one observation. I think Commissioner Ball may owe Lisa an apology. She took umbrage of that county comment.